Right now at 6, an update on a Bob Norman Local 10 News investigation about a case of possible excessive force at the hands of two Broward Sheriff's deputies. We first brought you the story last night at 11 of a man seen being knocked unconscious by Broward Sheriff's deputies at a Deerfield Beach gas station. It's video first obtained by Local 10.
We are the only station to talk with that man, who tells Bob he intends to file a federal lawsuit. And now those deputies are off the streets. Here's Bob with an update.
The man being struck and then slammed face first to the pavement by two Broward Sheriff's deputies, 50-year-old David Gonzalez, says he has a feeling this wasn't the first time.
They probably have done this before and they have been getting away with it.
As this video was being played across the media, another excessive force case was coming to the surface. This one involving Jorge Rodriguez and his wife Maria Rentel in a 2009 case that ended this past December with the sheriff's office paying out a $350,000 settlement in taxpayers' money to the couple.
He's a nice guy, I mean, friendly guy, friendly neighbor. I mean,
Rodriguez neighbor Carmine Genovese said it happened when deputies arrived at a party at Gonzalez's house involving loud music.
What did he tell you?
Just that they basically beat him up.
Like Gonzalez, Rodriguez claimed Deputy Justin Lambert, the bald deputy in the background, struck him without provocation. You can see that Gonzalez appears to have his hands out to be arrested just before he's hit, grabbed, and slammed to the ground. According to the federal lawsuit, Rodriguez also had his hands out like this, as if to be arrested, when Lambert allegedly tackled him, got him to the ground, pounded and pummeled him before tasering him several times. Now Gonzalez's attorneys, Eric Rudenberg and Mike Glasser, say they're preparing a federal lawsuit against BSO.
There's certainly a battery, an obvious battery, excessive use of force, a civil rights violation.
As for Deputy Lambert and Manresa, both today were taken off the road, put on limited desk duty, pending the outcome of this investigation. At the sheriff's office, I'm Bob Norman, Local 10 News.
Thanks a lot, and Bob tells us, too, that Deputy Lambert was never disciplined or even internally investigated by BSO for that previous excessive force allegation.